Hello people and welcome back to my A-frame house let's build. So, we've done the interior and now we get to do the exterior. So, that was pretty legit. What we're going to need is some grey stained clay and we are going to mark out. Well, no, that's not how you spell grey, you retard. There we go. Okay, so we're going to mark out how far we want this thing to be. So first, from the back of the house, just right here so you guys know the measurements. Right here, we are 3 blocks away from here, so we're just going to go 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah, I say 24 blocks in total. And then we will, of course, you guys don't need the measurements to this, because this is just a normal house width, and we've done all the measurements in previous videos for this. So basically, we're just connecting the walls together. Up with this wall and come back. Okay, and then all the walls need to be 2 blocks in height, of course. Okay, so let's just go to the front here. I don't think I did this originally. No, I did not. So we're just gonna go ahead and do this. No, when you place that. Yeah, I'm absolutely loving this A-frame house and just having a look at some of the A-frame houses on YouTube, mainly featured by Corralis, but you know there are a few others by independent builders, which is cool to see. Mine is actually quite unique from them, so that is what I was aiming for, and I'm pretty pleased of that. So I didn't want to have anything too similar, you know. I don't like copying people. I try not to, but if there's some really awesome designs, I'm probably going to use them. So what I've been thinking is we have a swimming pool out the back, right? Because we got a tennis court. In fact, we should probably border this thing off, so let's just get out some white stained clay. Let's just jump back 2 blocks, just like so. So we'll just leave it to here. And then you know what, we'll get some snow. And we'll just go 1, 2. Yeah, we'll just go 2 in height. So it just looks nice, just over the top here. This is just in case, you know, stops tennis balls going into the back garden a little bit, and it's just a sleek wall to give you a little bit of privacy from the road as well. You know what, we're going to put some fences here as well. So let's see, what walls do we have that look kind of nice? Cobblestone and mossy cobblestone, which looks poo. So we're not going to have that. So what we're going to do here is have some fences. I don't know if this will go with the cobblestone, so it's a bit of a guess. Disgusting. Yeah, we're just gonna have it like that, and then you know what, that's gonna be fine like that. We're gonna be happy about that. So over back here, I say we have some wood. Don't know which wood yet. What is that awesome looking wood? There we are, jungle wood. And the reason why I like this so much is the bottom just looks absolutely amazing, or the top, you know, whichever way around you really want it. And I just love using these for like little pathways and stuff, because they just look so gorgeous. And then what we can do is also get another type of wood out here, light wood. We don't want to go too heavy, so let's use oak. And we'll just put one in here, here and here. Then we will get some, actually no, what are them things called, PO something. Yeah, we'll get that. I don't even know how to say that, what the hell. And we'll just put a few of these around here. Obviously I want some trees in my garden, because you know they look cool. So we'll have a tree here. I'm just trying to think of what that awesome tree was called. It's a fairly new tree. Dark oak, is it? Or is it this one? I think it's this tree, guys. I'm not entirely sure. And then we will bone mill you. Just get out some bone mill, of course. And then just set it down on here. Yeah, that is, wow, okay, that is one interesting design. I am actually really liking that, because I've never seen any of these trees ever look like that. Okay, and hopefully guys my audio is a little bit better this time. I knew in the previous episode I was talking a bit quietly, and also there's this really annoying noise in the background, like this high-pitched fuzz, and I was just really, really pissed by that. So I'm sorry about that. I did put annotation in the video apologizing, and hope you guys don't dislike it for that, because I put a lot of time into that video, so, you know, sorry, I didn't want it to be like that. I had no idea why it happened. Come back to watch, please, but, you know, happens, shit happens, you just gotta deal with it, I guess. So we're gonna just have this derpy looking design of torch thingy, my Bob. Yeah, that is real derp. You know, looks cool, provides some light, keeps the bats away, because they are annoying. Out here we can just have some shelving units. You know what, let's get out some black thingy and some black thingy, and just along, where can we have that? Where can we have you? You can go here. So, you know, that's just like a little shelving unit where they can just put their outside thingies, and I'm liking that. Right, so now what we're gonna need is some water, some, what is that awesome stone called? I think it's cracked stone, right? Well, guys, this, I keep giving variations. People, especially on my Instagram, which is where my main fan base is held for my YouTube, like responding to you guys, answering frequent questions and all that kind of stuff, you know, and just replying to fans, because I love doing it, and it's amazing to see that I've actually got something like 3,500 followers now of active people, which is just, you know, friggin' amazing, considering this channel has 600 subs, but, you know, still pretty cool. And what I try and do mainly is just give a little bit of variation of materials, because I know most of you guys are building these on Xbox, which, you know, you probably wouldn't expect. Personally, I've always preferred, you know, Minecraft on PC. You get the biggest render distance, you get the coolest mods and all that awesome stuff. Texture packs are so much cooler. I mean, flows HD, right? Some people don't like it, but hundreds of thousands do, so yeah, I'm going with that. And it's just an awesome pack. Truly, guys, if you want to experience Minecraft, biggest servers, best texture packs, most awesome looking mods, coolest stuff, get a PC. You know, it doesn't have to be the best, but get a desktop, trust me. I made the mistake of getting a laptop, which I'm using at the moment. You know, £550, $800 I spent on this thing about a year ago, and yeah, biggest mistake. If I would have got a desktop for that money, I would be running these settings. Wow, I could be running shaders at mid to high settings here, getting 60 FPS. But yeah, this is the ultimate experience. And what I've got planned is some really nice little palm trees around here, mini dirt palm trees, little swimming pools, some lounges, you know, some cool design and modern stuff going on, and we could design something pretty awesome here. So of course a pool. I mean, these guys own a fat old A-frame house, they're gonna want a nice pool outside. Not humongous, but pretty awesome. Almost done. Yeah, so I was saying, like, cracked stone, you can use other materials. Black stained clay looks cool for pools, blue stained clay looks amazing. Quartz looks cool. I'm actually using these chiseled quartz blocks for the bottom of pools, because they lighten it up, especially at night time on shaders mod, like I've said before, and anyone that has shaders knows exactly what I'm talking about. At night time, Ruta Plays is dark, and I don't mean just dark, it's like you can't see anything. It looks awesome, the lighting is so smart, but yeah, it is pretty much like black in your face. Alright, so come on, place down. Now this is where I could really do with some world edit. My server is down at the moment and not for donations, so if you guys want to help me out, get the server out, well, technically I'm saving up so you guys can come on and experience and build with your friends, but unfortunately it is costing quite a lot, because we need a very requiring server. I mean, the world edit we are doing on there for the spawn at the moment is like mind-blowing, and we need a lot of RAM, a lot of slots for a lot of builders before it's good to public to come on. So if you guys want to help donate in my about page, there's a PayPal symbol. Don't worry, it's totally legit and safe, because, you know, it is PayPal. All your money, 100% of it will go towards that. So if you could do that, I would be very grateful. And on the server, you know, maybe for a day or two, we could promote you and help you out if you have a YouTube or something. We just want to get this server up as quick as we can. So we're going to have these glowstone thingies, oh no, in line, because you know, I know you guys with OCD. So we're just going to have two here. We're not going to have a huge range of lights, but you know what, that looks cool. Actually, I was maybe thinking, right, we can, you know, put the levels up a little bit. It'll look a little bit nicer. And I'm sorry about these lines, but it's one thing that Riddle plays doesn't look amazing. No, doesn't look amazing. And unfortunately, every few blocks you have these really disgusting looking derpy lines of basically where they haven't quite sorted out the water. Yeah, but you know, it's an awesome texture pack. They deserve credit. It's just, this is one thing they do need to sort out. So slabs, I'm thinking quartz, right? Matches the bottom of the pool. And what this will do is it will hide, that. We can say people can just sit on there in the middle, you know, maybe children's area, adults area, you get where I'm coming from. And right, now with these mini derp palm trees, we can just have some of these jungle leaves because they are the best looking leaves ever invented. Alright, so this is how we do this. Just, these are really mini dirt palm trees, guys, so don't judge, you know. Okay, so what can we do here? Maybe to side up one, and how does that look? You know what, that actually does not look half bad. So we're just going to go like that. Go like this, go like this. This is my first time making like a miniature palm tree. It's not actually that mini, but before I've built some pretty small palm trees. I mean, pretty large palm trees that really did not plan out. Okay, awkward commentary. There we go. Again. And then we're just gonna do the other sides, and then we'll just be all done, and things will be cool. All right, and then two more sides to go. And there we go, mini dirt palm tree. You know what, I'm actually really pleased with that design. Okay, so now we got that, what we're going to want to do is get out some snow. We'll just go 1, 2, 3, and then just bring that up one. Then 1, 2, 3. And then we will just have, I guess, some little chairs on the other side of jungle wood to, you know, match the trees and all that cool stuff. That is pretty smart. I'm liking that. And then maybe just another little mini derp chair there. And that's pretty much our swimming pool design done. What we're going to do now is just get some stone slabs and just go around the outside with it. You know, just bordering it off from everything else so it's separated. And it will just give it a slightly cleaner look. And then we can just get some nice flowers. So we get poppy, dandelion, whilst that, whatever that's called. Then we just go. Just place these randomly, guys. These don't have to be like positioned perfectly. You just want a few of them. And then we just go around with dandelions. Just one there, and then we'll just finish it off by putting one here. Then we'll go around with this, whatever this is called. I'm not even gonna attempt to say that because it will go wrong. See, like that, and how beautiful does that look, right? I mean, so simple. That was a really easy little build there, but turned out to be pretty cool. I reckon another cool feature that we can have here is an outdoor cinema. Right, so we're going to need some black stained clay. And we'll just bring this all the way to the floor and we'll have it an old-fashioned style TV. I say that because all the new ones are so much different. Then we'll get our iron. If you're using Flows HD, yes, my iron is slightly different to yours. I prefer it to look like this. I think it looks so awesome. I made it myself, actually. Then we're going to get our item frames, right? Actually, let's see. Jukeboxes, what do they look like? They can work. They can definitely work. Actually, no. An even slicker design would be signs. So what we're going to do, we're just going to go drop down. Drop down. And then done. And then we got our outdoor cinema. So what we're going to have now is we're going to get out some quartz, right? And we'll just have some Mahusif old seeds. You know, so if you have a family or something, you can just be watching it like that, just cash. And we'll just have two of them seats there, you know. You could fit like four or five people on here. We don't really need a lot of people, just enough. Then some torches on fences, because if you've ever seen some outdoor cinemas, or you go to America where they actually have drive-in cinemas, which I've actually been to, and they are so cool, literally in England, it sucks. We don't have any of that cool stuff. We just have like a couple of like mosquito repellent things, because we don't really want any of them, you know. I'm just trying to think of everything. So we've got a swimming pool, just a nice little tree area. Of course we'll put some more palm trees around. It's just quite difficult to think of what to do next, if you know what I mean. Actually, instead of have our solar panels on the roof, because they do look beautiful, but you know, on an A-frame it's quite difficult. I mean, where the hell do we put these things, right? What we can have over here is we'll just have some strips of these. So, you know, just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then we'll just go 2. And we'll just repeat this. And what these can be is these can just, you know, provide hot water from the house. Just imagine there's like an invisible sort of, you know, cable going underground here. And again, we will use stone slabs just to separate this from the build, you know. We're going with this clean sort of sleek look to our A-frame just to make everything look a little bit nicer. Like everything is sectioned off. That's kind of the idea. Not going to section off the TV, of course, you know, that's just open. What else can we put here, right? I'm just trying to think, because it's actually quite difficult. What do you have when you come out of house? Okay, we're gonna put down some bone meal, because that will just make it look a little bit more like a garden. Actually, no, before we even do that, green stained clay. And we're just gonna... This, again, guys, doesn't have to all be put down like... exactly where I put it. So it was just bam 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 bam. And basically, you know, we'll just create a few random strips, and what this will be is this will be like in gardens. If you've ever seen mown lawn, like mowed lawn looks fantastic, looks awesome. If you have like an expensive lawnmower, you'll know what I'm talking about. And this will just give it a nicer look and make it look a little bit more like a garden, you know, because gardens aren't completely just grass. They have like nice stripes of sort of different colored grass, which looks quite awesome. And if we have it all together perfectly, it won't actually look that great. So let's see what we can do. This is a new method. It may go wrong, it may look good, you know, we're gonna find out. Yeah, so this is gonna be a bit of an experiment. We don't really know what is gonna happen and what it's gonna look like, but if it does turn out, you know, I might actually start something new, like someone started the carpet units. That was awesome. If you think about it though, mowed lawn isn't like all perfect. Yeah, it's mainly straight, but these are straight, right? But it does have curves and bends in it, for example, and this may just give it a little bit of life. design. At the moment it looks really derp, but we will of course edit out the design a little bit. So I think these, for example, these do need to be one. They just look like huge fat green stains at the moment, and that's something that doesn't look amazing. So we'll keep it like that, keep that like this, then we will get some green carpet and we will just go alongside like so. Dirt hair as well. And what this will do is it will just help out with the lines, and it will also make it look a little bit smoother. Well, you know, roughen out them edges where it is a little bit too derp. You know, it's kind of like mid derp at the moment. It's not fully like derp, but we are shaping it. Gotta remember that. Okay, so this right here, this needs to be removed. Kind of looks cool, like abstract sort of designs, but wow, I actually kind of like it quite a bit. Right, now what we're going to do is we're going to go over with some bone meal, and I had a little idea for that corner. Come on, bone meal, don't escape me. Alright. So not too much of this stuff, otherwise it's just going to look like a flipping jungle. We just want just little, you know, dots of it, because it does grow rapidly. Okay, almost done. We'll just leave this corner out for now, and we won't go too near the cinema, because you know what, they don't really want grass in their face when they're watching TV. Alright, so you see that adds a little bit more. Now over here, I have thought of an amazing idea. I mean, this is awesome. So let's see, four. No, we need a bit bigger than this. Almost done. Okay. So in the corner here, we're just going to have a hoop of it. I'm going to place it like this. Right, no, don't fall in the hole. That's not part of the plan. Then we will need a fence, which I've already got out. Mucked up again. We'll just place that here, and then we would literally, ready? And stained clay. There you go, that is a really, really dark thing. But what this is supposed to be, right, is a putting green. So we just put here, like that, you know, and then we have, I don't know, another one here. And what these are just the putters. Can we actually, you know, find anything? What do we have? We don't want them to look like huge hockey sticks. If we can, that would be good to avoid that. I don't know, is there anything that we can use? So maybe grey carpet, but that looks a little bit too spread out. Yeah, it does. Oh well, we're just going to keep it like that, and you know, it's kind of cool, we're going to just stay with that design, I like it. So, I'm really liking this, exteriorly wise, is a mahoosive house. I mean, look at that plot, right? This is just my own world, guys, it's in the server, download will be available when I complete all these homes, but you know, for now, it's going to just stay like this. That is pretty derp, we do need to, you know, do something else, I'm not sure yet, I'm just thinking. Okay, right, so I just came up with some ideas that I just paused. I was like, actually, what the hell do I build? So, what I think we can have here is like a little canopy, right? Because we could do with some shade just outside. Wow, okay. I could not spell spring there for a second. My mind just froze. That's never happened before, but, you know. It is actually 3 a.m. here, so I'm actually really surprised how I'm managing to, you know, have the energy to actually do this video, but I had to get it out. My mom was like, get it out. Otherwise, you know, a gap of 2 days without videos, not good for views, not good for subscribers, and obviously you guys would say, you know, it's bad. So, we had to get this video out. I had no choice. My mom was telling me to do it. So, we're going to have a little grey canopy here. We're going to also have some lounges. Some more lounges. You know what? That's not exactly in line because I wanted it to be like that. It kind of does look like it's floating, but imagine, right? It just slides into the roof seamlessly. You just got to imagine some times with Minecraft. You know, it's not the most advanced game. you don't have everything, of course. Cool stuff does come out and have like updates and stuff, but you know, for now, this is all we got, and you gotta be creative. Right, so we're just gonna have a, like a little thingy here, like what do you call it? Umbrella thingy. That's it. That's all my mind can think of at the moment. Yeah. And we're gonna have this here, and then we're gonna have a little chair underneath. I don't know what you call them. You get them at like beaches. You know, some people have them in your garden, and they just protect you from the sun, and you know, you can just sit around them. So we're gonna have that here. We are gonna get. Now this may look dark. Actually no, let's just use some oak ones. I was thinking about having stone because I wanted grey lounges, but that ain't gonna happen. Just have one here, and you know, just a mini like kid lounger there, because that's cool. And then over here we can just have, actually no, not that material. We will go for stone. Because we need to have a little bit more stone in our builds. Then you just got like a little table design, you know. It adds. And then what we can do is we can just add a little bit of detail. So we'll just have some ladders on the outside. Bam, bam. And these are like towel racks, because when you get out of the pool, you're going to need towels, and you will need racks for that. And that's pretty much the most legit answer I could come up with. So that is the garden done, guys. Now I will give you a little spin. So hold on a sec, let me adjust my settings, and then we can get a smooth spin around this build. Travels, proving the time can hack all. Midnight battles, losing your mind.
Give the video a like if you enjoyed this video, you enjoyed this series, and if you enjoyed the build, of course. And I want to hear what you guys think I should build next, because I honestly have no idea. A-frame, sleek house, modern house, you know, whatever, just drop a suggestion down below and I'll be very grateful for that. And please smack that subscriber button, tell me get to 700 subscribers, which is my new small goal. I think we're only like 55 away now, so if you could help me progress towards that, that would also be awesome. So thank you guys so much for watching so far, and I will see you guys in my next house video. See you later.